In this video, I will show you the PDP-11 computer. The PDP-11 is a series of mini computers built starting from the late 70s and built in several versions. You can see here a PDP-1134 computer. These machines were used mainly for data analysis, but the PDP you can see here has been used also for computer music. With this machine, the Italian inventor Giuseppe Di Giugno developed the 4i processor board, which is among the first sound processor board to be used in real time for real-time sound processing with this calculator. Also, this calculator, together with the 4i processor board, has been used for famous compositions like Prometeo by Luigi Nono. As you can see here, the machine consists in several cards. The CPU is not a single chip integrated circuit, but is made with two boards that contain several TTL chips and of course some registers and many TTL chips. Then we have this card which controls this console on the front panel. Here you can program the PDP-11 with this octal display to see the addresses and data, and you have this numeric keypad to enter the addresses and the data you want to deposit inside the memory. This is the memory card. Also, we have a serial card to talk with a serial terminal. We have the floppy drive controller card, as the machine came with two 8-inch floppy drive. Then we have the 4i controller card. With these connectors, we can talk with the 4i sound processor board, which is installed outside from the machine. Then we have another controller card to control the external removable hard drive. This is the external removable hard drive, and this is the rack where the PDP was installed. Also, this one are the original discs that have been preserved. I read these discs to preserve the content in matters of flux variation. Here you can see the grant continuity cards that must be installed where there are no other boards installed in these slots. Here we have the termination card, the bus terminator, and here we have the bootstrap terminator, which contains some PROM chips that will let the computer boot from a device or from another, from floppy or from hard drive. At the back of the machine, we have the power cord, and we can see that the power supply consists in several modules, one for each supply voltage. Now I will show you how to write a character on the terminal screen. The first thing to do is to put the address of the transmit buffer, which is 777566. Load address, Then I have to type the octal representation of the character ASCII value. I want to show on the screen an uppercase B, so I have to put 1, 0, 2. Now, when I will press the deposit key, an uppercase B will appear on the screen. You can see here the uppercase B, as we expected to see. Now I want to show you more in detail what I did with the floppy disks. I read them as magnetic flux variation pattern, which is contained in this raw file, which is the raw dump of the disk. Then I converted it to a floppy disk image, which is this file here. And as you can see, what I found is are the source codes of the programs written for the 4i processor board. And you can see here a small part of them on this screen.